Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome back to the final day of the Victor Dixon High School graduation 2023. We are operating still under the theme, unlocking the door to new possibilities. We're about to begin. May I invite you to stand for the procession.
Thank you. Please stand for our opening prayer. O God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, we are indeed grateful for your blessings upon the Victor Dixon High School. Today we gather to celebrate the hurdles, the trials, the joy that this graduating class 2023 have gone through and are here to celebrate today. We thank you for the leading of your Holy Spirit in the life of these graduates. We thank you for the provision and insight that you have made in allowing their parents to allow them to be educated at this noble institution. We praise you for their principal, vice principal, teachers, members of the board, and all those who have contributed to this successful moment. We pray that you'll be with today's proceedings. Bless our guest speaker. And when all is said and done, let your name be glorified and magnified. And let this serve as a witness that indeed true education is the best. In your name I pray. Amen. Please be seated.
At this point in time, we will continue with the welcome by Brianna Sharp, Renicia Thomas, Livani Hansen, followed by our greetings from our president, the president of Northern Caribbean University, represented by Dr. Nani Bala Paul, and followed by the greetings from Pastor Michael Henry, Education Director, Jamaica Union Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. Thank you.
Miss Orchid Smith, Principal, her husband, Dr. Joseph Smith, Dr. Lincoln Edwards, President of Northern Caribbean University, represented by Dr. Charlene Sharp, Associate Provost for University Administration, Dr. Nanabala Paul, Associate Provost for Academic Affairs, Northern Caribbean University, and Chairman of the Board of Governors, Victor Dixon High School, and her husband, Dr. Emmanuel Paul, Pastor Michael Henry, Education Director, and other representatives of the Jamaican Union Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, Mrs. Roseanne McCoy Chambers, Education Director, Central Jamaica Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, other members of the Board of Governors of Victor Dixon High School, Mrs. Heather Silvera, Lecturer and Coordinator of the Nurse Practitioner Program and Nurse Practitioner University of the West Indies, guest speaker and family, specially invited guests, administrators, staff, and students of Victor Dixon High School, alumni, faculty, guardians, and friends joining us physically and on our virtual platform, members of the graduating class of 2023, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon.
It is with great pleasure that we welcome you on behalf of the graduates to the Victor Dixon High School Graduation Ceremony 2023.
As we reflect on our time here, we are reminded that we have been through a monumental theme park. We rode on a roller coaster of emotions created by the COVID-19 pandemic.
We've also had to Ferris wheel through the ups and downs of the high school life.
We have had to go through a carousel of subjects.
We balance our studies with our personal lives.
And juggle the multiple responsibilities. Yet through such feats, we've persevered, and we stand here today as graduates to welcome you to share in this grand finale, or graduation.
We owe a debt of gratitude to many people who have supported us, applauded us, pushed us along the way with, you can do it, good job, keep it up, I am proud of you. And now
today, we are here to give it right back to you.
So to our families, our friends, our teachers, and our mentors, welcome to our graduation 2023. We will snap,
tweet,
DM you.
Until then,
bye everyone.
Mrs. Orchid Smith, principal, and her husband, Dr. Joseph Smith, Dr. Lincoln Edward Paul, president of Northern Caribbean University, Pastor Michael Henry, education director, Jamaica Union Conference, Mrs. Roxanne Chambers, education director, Central Jamaica Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, board members, Mrs. Heather Silvera, lecturer and coordinator of Nurse Practitioners Program and Nurse Practitioner, West Indies, University of the West Indies, our guest speaker, special invited guests, administrators, staff, students, alumni, faculty, guardians, friends, parents, members of the graduating class of 2023, ladies and gentlemen. It's my honor to read the message from the President of Northern Caribbean University, Dr. Lincoln Paul Edwards, today. Now let me start by extending heartiest congratulations to the graduates. You made it. Today is an exciting day as you and your loved ones are celebrating the culmination of 5 years of hard work, of sleepless nights, and of tears. Yes, I know some of you have shed a tear or two or many when that math problem just seemed unsurmountable, when you just could not find the right words to produce that excellent essay, when the diagram of human anatomy just could not stick so that you could label it correctly on your final exam, or when your heart broke to learn the atrocities that our foreparents endured so that you could have the opportunity for a high school education. Furthermore, it may seem like a lifetime ago when you walked through the gates of Victor Dixon High School, and now 5 years later, you're part of a graduating class. And how did you become a member of the graduating class? Because the administrators, the teachers, and the staff at the Victor Dixon High School took vested interest in you, provided sage advice, and helped you to unlock the door to new possibilities. But you are also a part of graduating class because you were willing to put in the efforts that it took to succeed. You came, you saw, and you conquered the syllabi by getting good grades. You made lifelong friends who helped you to endure the challenges of high school and helped you to grow into the person you are today. You participated in extracurricular activities. You sang on the choir. You did valuable volunteer service, and you actualize the mission of your alma mater by participating in active integration of faith and learning. Now that you have reached to this level of graduation, we congratulate you. However, as stated in your printed program, in your case, possibilities mean that there is a very good chance that the plans that you have put in place will be realized. It means that your hopes and dreams will most likely be realized if you work diligently towards them. On the other hand, if you fail to put plans in place, then your possibilities would more than likely be thwarted. Benjamin Franklin, who is credited with being one of the founding fathers of the United States of America. Put it this way, if you fail to plan, you are planning to fail. I repeat again, if you fail to plan, you're planning to fail. Did you get that? If you fail to plan, you're planning to fail. And I did like to believe that none of you fall into this category. In fact, now that you are graduating from high school and continuing plans for your future, we invite you to come in and talk with us here at Northern Caribbean University, and we can assist you in enrolling in one of the many undergraduate programs that fit your interests. We also have several scholarships for which you can apply as you endeavor to unlock the door to new possibilities. These are the scholarships: IAD Campari Scholarships, Atlantic Caribbean Union Scholarships, Jamaica Union Scholarship, Early Bird Grants, Online Awards, the Vice President Scholarships, the President Scholarship, and the School of Religion and Theology Scholarship. To learn more about these scholarships, you can go to the homepage of NCU Scholarship, and then or talk to our very able team members at the Office of Admissions and Enrollment. And remember that you, as you unlock the door to new possibilities, you are not doing so only for yourself. You are paving the way for others to follow. You are serving as a source of inspiration for your siblings and others in your community. You are making your parents, your teachers, and yourself proud. You are contributing to the building of Jamaica, land we love. You are becoming a valuable global citizen, and most importantly, you are preparing to become a citizen of heaven. So congratulations once again on being part of the graduating class of 2023. And remember that you can do all things. You can do all, not some, but all things. God bless you all. And now, the greetings from my office, the Office of Academic Affairs at Northern Caribbean University, and also from the board, Victor Dixon School Board. Dear graduates, congratulations on this momentous occasion of your graduation from Victor Dixon High School, an institution based on Adventist philosophy of education. I'm proud that you have worked hard and reached this significant milestone in your life. The journey may not have been an easy one for you, your parents, or your teachers, but through it all, God has journeyed with you, leading to this great achievement. As you move forward, certainly with your theme, Unlocking the Doors of New Possibilities, it is telling that you are not about to stop halfway on this journey, for there are higher heights and endless possibilities to dive into. But always remember that Jesus Christ is the true door, and through him men shall go in and out and find pastures. Additionally, as you advance into new possibilities, I urge you to take the words of the well-known author Ellen G. White with you. Success is not result of chance or of destiny. It is the working of God's own providence, the reward of faith and discretion of virtue and persevering effort. So dream big. Have faith and virtue, persevere hard, and progress through the door, Jesus Christ, to reach new possibilities and new heights, and create a brighter future for yourself and for those around you. The Office of the Academic Affairs at Northern Caribbean University and the Victor Dixon School Board are delighted about your success, and may God bless you abundantly as you exit the classrooms of Victor Dixon High School and unlock the door to new possibilities with God by your side. Congratulations. God bless you all abundantly.
Members of the Board of Governors, principal and staff of this noble institution, parents, friends, well-wishers, and of course, and especially, members of the graduating class of 2023. This is a moment to remember, a milestone moment and full of mixed emotions. The administration and staff, while they are so busy ensuring that today's program is a success, are also flushed with a feeling of pride and accomplishment. Parents are beaming with pride as they look at their children who are achieving a major milestone in life. But even so, they can't help wondering, where will they find the money to finance the next leg of the journey? Graduates are happy and relieved because they realize that they have made it, and they are excited about the prospect of moving on to higher education. At the same time, they are anxious also about financing further education and whether or not they'll be able to handle college work and the emotions and pressures of higher education. Indeed, it's a privilege to share this special moment with you and to extend greetings on behalf of Jamaica Union and especially the Department of Education. During this period, your sister schools are also celebrating another year of success and another batch of students who are leaving. And we who have been given oversight of this great enterprise of Christian education are also elated at the continuing success of our schools and of our young people. Members of the class of 2023, we are living in challenging times. The cost of living is high, and just meeting day-to-day expenses is almost impossible for some persons. Jobs are difficult to find. Crime and violence pose a threat to all of us, and the standards of society are just simply eroding all around us. This is the world in which you will have to climb the next rung on the ladder of success. And yet, there's no need to fear, because in this institution, you have been given the keys to success. So as you go, there are three things I would like to say to you. First, do not forget your school. Do not forget the teachers who nurtured you, the friends who cared about you, the valuable life lessons that you learned in this institution. And whenever you get an opportunity, give back to the system that has given so much to you. Second, while you're in school, you learn about God, His love, His power, and what can happen when you exercise your faith in Him. Put Him first in everything you do. Follow His commands. Let His words be your guide as you make each important decision in life, and success will be guaranteed to you. Finally, remember that you belong to God, that you are here for a purpose. You cannot think and behave as others do because you are different, you are special. Always stand for truth and principle. Seek to make this world a better place. Spread love and happiness and kindness everywhere you go, following the example of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. In all of this, we'll be praying for you and cheering you on. So go with our love and go with God's richest blessings. I thank you.
Dr. Lincoln Edwards, President of Northern Caribbean University in absentia. Dr. Nanibala Paul, Associate Provost for Academic Affairs, Northern Caribbean University, and Chairman of the Victor Dixon High School Board of Governors. Pastor Michael Henry, Education Director, excuse me, and other representatives from Jamaica Union Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, Mrs. Roxanne McCoy Chambers, Education Director, Central Jamaica Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, other members of the Board of Governors of the Victor Dixon High School. I see Dr. Daniel Alida. Welcome, Dr. Alida. Mrs. Heather Silvera, lecturer and coordinator of the Nurse Practitioner Program, a nurse practitioner, University of the West Indies, guest speaker, and family members, specially invited guests, administrators, staff, and students of the Victor Dixon High School, alumni, faculty, guardians, and friends joining us physically and on the virtual platform, members of the graduating class of 2023, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure this afternoon to introduce our guest speaker of the moment. Her name, Heather Dawn Silvera. But years ago, when we sat in high school together, she was Heather Hall, a very persistent and determined young lady. Heather Dawn Silvera is a lecturer and a coordinator of the Nurse Practitioner Program at the University of the West Indies School of Nursing, MONA, since September 2016. She is a registered nurse. She is a registered midwife. She holds a postgraduate diploma in education. She is a family nurse practitioner. She holds a master's in nursing, and she is a PhD candidate, an ABD all but dissertation, which she is now completing. Heather has been a practicing family nurse practitioner for over 12 years. She has worked in several health centers in the primary healthcare setting in Jamaica. Her experience led her to coordinate the chronic diseases portfolio for the parishes of Kingston and St. Andrew for 4 years. In 1996, and she graduated from the Kingston School of Nursing, she was subsequently employed at the Bustamante Hospital for Children for 5 years. Heather successfully completed her certificate as a registered midwife from the University Hospital in 2001. Her love for nursing propelled her ambition to practice in an advanced nursing role. This led her to qualify herself further with a master's degree. Upon completion, she pursued the program for 2 years and gained the postgraduate diploma in education and training. Her quest for higher academic achievement led her to begin reading for her doctoral degree, which she began in 2020. Mrs. Silvera's time is now consumed with lecturing, coordinating the master's program for nurse practitioners, preparing manuscripts for publication, church activities. After all, she is an elder at the 10th City SDA Church in St. Catherine, Jamaica. She is always striving to remain faithful to God. All these responsibilities are coupled with a loving and supporting her husband Aaron of over 23 years. She has two daughters, Simone and Nalia, and one of her daughters and other family members are here. If you're inside, will you just stand and be acknowledged? Where are you? All right. Okay, welcome. Thank you so much. She has two daughters, as I said, a grandson, Jaden, and a son-in-law, Jeremy. In high school, her persistent efforts paid off, and she was successful. She charted a course for her life, and I'm proud today to be her classmate. I remember Heather doing JCDC speech festival with you decades ago, and the love you had for just exploring and getting things done, that love has not subsided. And so we welcome you to the Victor Dixon High School, formerly West Indies College High School, an old tramping ground for you, a school that nurtured you and taught you to be ambitious and to soar in your career. It is my pleasure to be able to welcome a past classmate to speak to the current class of 2023. Yes, ChatGPT and all the various devices are current, but the educated, the intellectual, the committed to God will still have a word for the current generation. So without further ado, I want to welcome Mrs. Heather Dawn Silvera to the platform to address you. May I invite a round of applause for her as she comes.
Thank you, Mrs. Orchid Smith, for your kind words of introduction. While coming this afternoon, I was speaking to my sister and my daughter when we did that JCDC festival. And I still remember my piece in Pages of the Past. I will not repeat it now. To the school board, the principal of Victor Dixon High School, the teachers, and the graduating class of 2023, ladies and gentlemen, it is an awesome privilege to be your guest speaker here today. Your theme is Unlocking the Door to New Possibilities. It is so appropriate as this chapter of high school is now closed. This chapter of your life is now closed. And you are on the verge of exploring new possibilities. Allow me to slip in my title for my discourse, which is Stepping In. Yes, you are going to unlock the door of new possibilities. But when you unlock a door, you can step back and not enter. You can step in. You can stand around. You can look. You can get out and close the door. But if you step in, you can examine and see what is inside that room. Any one of you or any of these, you can choose, and your choice will be determined by your outcome. So let's step into new possibilities for a few minutes. And graduating class, I'm going to ask you to speak with me because I'm going to speak with you directly. Let's examine the word possibility. A thing that may happen or be the case. Another definition, the state or fact of being possible, the likelihood of possibilities. A thing that may be chosen or done out of several possible alternatives. And this is the one I like best. The third one I will adopt. Repeat with me, a thing that may be chosen or done out of several possible alternatives. Very good. So today is the beginning of a new chapter in your life. Each of you here will chart a different course. Some of you know what you would want to do in university or plan to pursue it accordingly. Others, your parents will advise or decide for you what you should do in university. Some might be migrating. Others might be staying in Jamaica. Some of you may look for a job because the studying thing is not really your thing. For others, you will plan to work a while and return to your studies later. Whatever comes your way, know that it would be that thing that may be chosen or done out of several possible alternatives. Graduates, stepping in that door must come with an attitude of gratitude because you should appreciate the opportunities that come your way. When you unlock the door and step in, you may see another door you can use. You may see one window or several windows. Look at these as your possibilities. You can use a door to get out and go in another direction. You can open the windows for more lighting. The choice is yours. You must not murmur or complain because what you are facing may differ from what is anticipated. Remember that there are several ways to reach your destination. The path may be straightforward, but it may also be going on different avenues to reach your destination. We're at Northern Caribbean University now, and you want to go to Mandeville Town. How many different ways you have to reach? Tell me. Anybody? You can go through Keep Left and Keep Left. You can go straight. You can even turn Newport and go all the way around, don't it? Several ways to reach Mandeville. What I'm saying, graduates, is that you will reach, but don't be in a rush. Your way of reaching might be different from the other classmate, but you will reach. As you step in, you may see a mirror. And now I ask that each of you take a look in that mirror. I'm looking in that mirror, and it's me that I'm seeing. Now ask yourself how I want to see myself in the next 5 years, in the next 10 years, in the next 15 years. Am I looking at an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur. You can take anything. You can be a farmer and you can supply an industry. You can be a cabinet maker, carpenter, and you can supply an industry. Do you want to be a nurse? A teacher? A doctor? A businessman or woman? A pastor? A lawyer? A secretary? A police? A soldier? Fashion designer? Am I leaving out anyone? Am I leaving out anyone? What do you want to be in life? You name it, the choice is yours. Or, as I look in the mirror, am I looking at someone without a dream? One who lacks integrity. One that others will point the finger at in disdain. Graduates, you can be someone that the Victor Dixon High School Board can speak about with pride, or one that the Victor Dixon High School Board will never utter your name. What will be your new possibilities? What will it bring? Will you choose a path that exemplifies the virtues you learned these past years? Will the morals of Christian upbringing guide your options? Will your potential be driven by a positive outlook matched with good character? Will your prospects have the blessings of Christ? Your decision can only govern these alternatives when you unlock the door to new possibilities. I will not give you a presentation that is not matched with reality. Difficulties will come, failures and disappointments too, but the motivation is, when you find yourself in these situations, remember you are never alone. Find someone to talk to, a parent, a sibling, a teacher, or a trusted friend. Pray about it, and if you don't think that your prayer is enough, have someone pray with you and ask God to help you through these difficulties. Take a far away look. Do some introspection to see if you need to be aware of any faults that you may have. Do some introspection and see if the Lord is holding you back from other difficulties that you may encounter. Trials come to make you stronger. Be thankful for what you have. As you embark on your new possibilities, let me share a poem with you that I learned as a little girl. The world is mine. Today upon a bus, I saw a girl with golden hair. She seemed so gay, I envied her. I wish I was half as fair. I watched her as she rose to leave, and I saw her hobble down the aisle. She had one leg and wore a crutch, but as she passed, a smile. Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I have two legs, the world is mine. Later on, I bought some sweets. The boy who sold them had such charm. I thought I'll stop and talk a while. If I were late, it would do no harm. As we talked, he said, "Thank you, sir. You have really been so kind. It's nice to talk to folks like you. You see, I am blind. Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I have two eyes. The world is mine." Later, walking down the street, I met a boy with eyes of blue. But he stood and watched the others play. It seemed he knew not what to do. I paused, and then I said, "Why don't you join the others, dear?" But he looked ahead without a word, and then I knew he couldn't hear. Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I have two ears, the world is mine. Two legs to take me where I go, two eyes to see the sunset glow, two ears to hear all I should know. Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I'm blessed indeed, the world is mine. Graduates, soon to be graduates, you are blessed. Congratulations, you did well. Unlock the door to new possibilities. Step in and see that the world is yours. Thank you.
So, Mrs. Heather Silvera, the graduates of the class of 2023 wish to express our deepest gratitude for your presence at our graduation exercise today, June 23, 2022. You have made today a truly special and memorable occasion for each of us graduates. You not only spoke with interesting intonation and expressive and engaging facial expression, but you spoke with confidence, clarity, and cogency. Yes. Okay. Great. So as we sat with great anticipation and we listened attentively, I must say your words have inspired us. It has inspired us to not be afraid of these open doors or these new doors to possibilities, but to step in bold and to be appreciative of every opportunity that we receive. We have gained valuable lessons that we will carry with us as we embark on our various journeys. Your words of encouragement and advice have given us the confidence to step into and to pursue these open doors of opportunities and possibilities. Once again, we, the members of the graduating class of 2023, thank you for making an indelible mark both on our impressionable minds and on this auspicious occasion. Thank you, and we present this gift of appreciation. Thank you.
That was truly appreciated. Thank you very much, guest speaker. My two items I remember from high school were Dark Africa was the title of my gold winning piece, and my silver winning piece was The Hungry Child, like gutters down the face of a nasty street. I remember starting my piece and intonating and exclaiming. And so there's so much you can remember. There's so much you can glean from education. Thank you so much, Madam Guest Speaker. Victor Dixon High School, formerly West Indies College High School, is a unique institution. We welcome students of varying academic abilities, and through integration and motivation, assist them in achieving great accomplishments. How else have we been sending off so many students to medical school, to engineering, to law, to science and technology careers? We little, but we tolerate. As we seek to mine gold from our students, we sometimes meet hurdles and obstacles. But just remember, we're mining gold from each of you. There is that wonderful possibility in each of you. And I would like to see each one of you achieving the dreams for your life, the goals for your life. I would like to meet you in 5 and 10 years' time to be able to congratulate you on achieving those goals for the first 5 and 10 years of your lives. So go forward and do well, and remember you have our prayers and our love. The tough love is finished. It will only be love from now. The principal's year in review will be shown on the screen. Thank you.
Greetings to you all on this, our 2023 graduation exercise. On behalf of the Board of Governors of the Victor Dixon High School, our staff, and our students, guided by our mission, our vision, and our core values, our theme, championing the mission for excellence, us to chart the course for the school year. As we strive to champion the mission for excellence, let us reminisce on the highlights of the school year so far. We champion the mission for excellence through the varied spiritual activities of the institution, the fall and spring moments with Jesus, baptisms, devotions, and Bible study. So many students, teachers, parents, and other stakeholders collaborating to create a rich experience.
9 students embraced Jesus this school year so far. We champion the mission for excellence in academics, affirming our students as they were roused to aim for the pinnacle of academic success at the annual honors convocation. Students and parents took great delight indulging in the wonderful moments and celebrated our highlights. Then the Owen Roberts Lecture Series and STEM Awards took center stage as the speaker, Dr. Casey Reed, explored the topic science, saving lives through the cutting edge of technology. Students who excelled in the sciences, technology, math, and engineering were spotlighted, and this together with scholarships of $100,000 to each of our 29 awardees for study at Northern Caribbean University from Dr. Owen Roberts, chief sponsor of the event, was well received. Also highlighted the achievement of over 25 recent past students currently enrolled or just recently completing medical school, and many engaged in other STEM and other business careers. In championing the mission for excellence, we partnered with Heritage Academy from Tennessee, USA, in an event in which our students were taught emergency response and disaster management techniques and skills, and parents were treated to a health fair, spa, nutrition, and regular health checks done at the annual Parent Teachers Conference in February. The team led by Dr. Joy and Derek Hamilton donated 10 new laptop computers to the business lab. We continue to champion the mission for excellence throughout the term by way of the enriching practical activities in horticulture, the culinary activities, building and construction, tiling. Then music returned to center stage in our participation at the NCU premiere event, the Feast of Lights, and later the Choir Festival, as well as our own outreach and internal musical events. Other activities included our Aspirational Career Day Fair, showcasing the dreams and ambitions of our students, Champion Students Reading Competition, Champion Students Heritage Quiz Competition, Refinement Luncheons, Badminton Competitions, Football Competitions, Heritage Queen Competitions, Modern Language Week Emphasis. Champion Student Sports Day embodied excitement and fanfare. The Heronites, the Falconites, and the Eagleites all happily contending to be crowned kings and queens of the track. The Eagleites, however, were the victors, and the red abounded all across the campus. College Rock Tea Competition, which culminated with a feature on CVM TV, saw Sheena McCalla, second form student, earning the highest GPA among the students in Manchester. Then we had our Honor Society and our High School Student Association, who were very active in planning spirit-filling affairs, even as World Cup football champions Brazil, Argentina, and France fans were predicting results. Our Parent Teacher Association and student leaders sponsored Teachers Day related programs and ventures for our faithful teachers and staff. Projects like our tank and badminton court construction have just been initiated, and we're eyeing completion in a short period of time. A new school song was launched, which will assist in further championing the mission for excellence. Writer Mrs. Benavis Crawford Reed and performer Mr. Wilton James, both alumni of the institution. We thank God for his leading, and so too we thank him for our re-energized alumni group led by Dr. Gloria Gregory, who have recommitted themselves to a high-impact approach to the institution. Thanks to our past chairman, Dr. Vivian Quarry, and our new chairman, Dr. Nanibala Paul, and the Board of Governors, and our committed staff, parents, and the wider stakeholders for their support. Victor Dixon High, formerly West Indies College High School, through our students will continue to aim to unlock the door to new possibilities under God. Thank you all, and may God bless Victor Dixon High as she champions the mission for excellence.
Good afternoon, everyone. Okay. Principal Smith, you cared for us not only as a principal, but as a mother who would want to see her children succeed. Whenever there was a display of misconduct, you were there to draw a line between right and wrong, enforcing the rules to guarantee our protection. Your support means the world to us. From ensuring that we are completing our SBAs to sending past papers and motivating us to study and to strive for success to ensure a bright and well-accomplished future. We appreciate your diligence, guidance, and dedication. Please know these we will carry with us through our journey in life. Teachers, there's a quotation that says, a truly great teacher is hard to find, difficult to part with, and impossible to forget. You all embody that person. For your prayers, your sometimes strong reprimands, your acts of giving in all the ways we needed you to, for being our away from home parents, we will forever owe you a debt you can never cash in. But as we grow and become what you envision for us, take pleasure in knowing that we are a part of your offering to the world. Thank you for having been a part of our growth and development and for making our high school years memorable ones. The 2023 graduating class thanks you.
Administrators and staff are the backbone of any school. They work tirelessly to ensure that students receive the best education possible. Their hard work and dedication often go unnoticed, but they are the ones who contribute most to the smooth day-to-day running of the institution. In essence, they are unsung heroes, and we were fortunate to have had their guidance and support. Miss Brown, Mr. Lawrence, Miss Wright, and Mrs. Harvey, our guidance counselor, who has moved on, you have all played a special role in our high school journey, whether it was from making sure we were registered for classes or for assisting us with printing, ensuring that we had our textbooks, or for any of the million and one requests that we made of you daily. We are deeply appreciative. Thank you. Another set of heroes are our support staff, Miss Law and Miss Miller. For me, and I know when I say your job is the most important, I mean, who can learn on an empty stomach? Thank you for the delicious meal, ladies. Mr. Simpson, Mrs. Thompson, and Miss Swaby, you played a big role in our safety by ensuring that the school compound is cared for properly so there are little to no injuries to students. As we move on from this beloved institution, we would like to say, on behalf of the class of 2023, and from the depths of our hearts, we appreciate you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our beloved parents, guardians, today it gives us great joy not just to be able to stand here as graduates, but as your children and charges.
There are not enough words to describe how grateful we are to you, our dear parents. We know that we are standing tall today on your shoulders. Shoulders that have borne us undenying love, selfless sacrifice, and unwavering support.
Thank you for guiding us, training us, molding us, and for financing us. Your seeds of encouragement, of patience, of commitment, and of unconditional love have been planted and have grown and will soon bear fruits.
Until then, we continue to need your prayers and presence in our lives. Yes, we still need you in times of failures and success, in times of troubles and triumphs, in our moments of joys and sorrows.
We salute you, our unsung heroes, our moms and dads. Today is not only our day, but it's yours too. To celebrate and bask in your hard work, we love and appreciate you.
Dear parents and guardians, would you please stand? Fellow graduates, please stand with me and let us give our treasures, our parents, a round of applause. I'm also asking that you find your parents, give them a hug, a thoughtful word, and pin their corsages. Please do so quickly and return to your seats so the program can continue.
Should you have need of the restroom, audience, it is to my left, your right, for you to refresh yourselves. Dr. Nadibala Paul, our board chair, and Mrs. Orchid Smith, our principal, it gives me great pleasure to present to you 45 graduates or students who have completed the requirements for graduation at Victor Dixon High School. Graduates, you are already standing. As you have practiced and your names are called, you will ascend the platform to receive your certificate or award. You will ascend on my left, your right, and you will do so until you are instructed to be seated. Audience, we're going to ask for you. I know this is a very exciting time, but we crave your attention and your participation by only applauding. Thank you. By only applauding as all of the graduates, or when all of the graduates have received their certificates. So, as you have practiced, I'm going to, yes, we have the members there ready for your receipt of the certificates. We will now invite the persons to announce the names to begin. As you have practiced, you may stand.
So we begin. Sarika Allen. She's followed by Shalina Allen.
And Shalene is receiving a prize for information technology in City and Guilds and social studies. The subject prizes are given to students who earned 90% and above in the subject areas, or who earn the highest grades in those subject areas.
Next to mount the stairs, Dylan Beadle.
And Dylan Beadle is receiving a subject prize award for technical drawing and deportment.
He is followed by the determined Sarabeth Burton.
And Sarabeth Burton is a graduate with distinction.
Yeah.
And graduates with distinction have earned GPAs of 3.5 and above. She is also the HISA president. And she is receiving subject prize awards for family resource management, physical education, food, nutrition, and health, biology, chemistry, mathematics, information science, and She's also the HISA president.
Aldania Codling. Aldenae Codling, corrected.
And Aldenae is a graduate with credit. Students with credit receive GPAs of 3.0 to 3.49. Aldenae is also the HISA Vice President, and she is receiving subject prize awards for Human and Social Biology, Bible, Family Resource Management, and Social Studies.
Aldenique Codling.
Aldenique is receiving a credit, and her subject prize awards are Family Resource Management and Physical Education.
Next to cross the stage, Shaquille Daniels. Peter Gay Ferguson. Azrael Forbes.
Azrael is receiving subject prize awards for Building Furniture Technology and Human and Social Biology. He also earned a CXC subject in third form.
Oren Ford. Al J. Foster. Peter Gordon, Jr.
And Peter Gordon is receiving awards for citizenship and deportment.
Now it's time for Levani Hansen.
Levani is receiving a credit award and awards in the subject areas of agricultural science, Bible, office administration, principal of business, and principles of accounts.
Quasia Jackson.
Quasia is receiving subject awards for electronic document preparation and management, sports and social studies.
We now have Jaheim Jenkins.
Jaheim Jenkins is receiving awards for building and furniture technology and deportment.
Lashara Johnson.
Lashara Johnson is graduating with credit and awards in human and social biology, Bible, deportment, and office administration.
And next is Malik Jones.
Malik is receiving an award in mathematics, City and Girls.
Rashawn Jones.
Rashawn is receiving awards in building and furniture technology, as well as geography.
He is followed by Alex Kirby. We will now have Adrian Lewis. Bjorn Lewis. That's right, John. The boy named Mom. Next is Nicolette McClarty.
And Nicolette is receiving an award in English language, City and Girls.
Damali McLean. Samuel Mekla.
Samuel is graduating with distinction. He is also the deputy head boy, and he is receiving awards in English language, Spanish, information technology, technical drawing, Bible, and citizenship. Biology, geography, physics, and he is the Joint Science Student of the Year. Samuel also took 3 CSEC subjects and passed them in the 3rd and 4th forms.
Danito. Danito Mori.
Danito is receiving awards in geography and the CSEC awards. He has also sat and passed 3 CSEC subjects in the 3rd and 4th form.
Nicholas Nemard.
Nicholas is receiving awards for food, nutrition, and health, as well as CSEC awards.
Javon Onywear.
Javon is receiving awards in deportment.
Joseph Onywear.
Joseph is a graduate with distinction. He has earned awards in chemistry, biology, Bible, technical drawing, mathematics, principle of business, physics, and he is the Joint Science Student of the Year. Joseph also sat 7 CSEC subjects and passed them in the 3rd and 4th forms.
Daniel Pinnock. Tanya Reed.
Tanya has earned awards in agricultural science and electronic document preparation and management.
Tywin Richards.
Tywin is graduating with credit as well as receiving subject awards in electronic document preparation and management and office administration.
Krishan Ricketts.
Krishan is a graduate today with credit, and he is receiving awards in electronic document preparation and management, agricultural science, and sports.
Jewel Robinson.
Jewel is receiving the award for English language, City and Guilds.
Joshua Sajabi. Rajay Shand. Brianna Sharp.
Brianna is receiving awards in food, nutrition, and health, and office administration. Brianna also sat 3 CXE subjects and passed them in the third and fourth form. Brianna is also the deputy head girl.
We will now have Joshie Smith.
Joshie is graduating with distinction, and she is the Victor Dixon High School head girl. She is receiving awards today in biology, chemistry, information technology, mathematics, Bible, physics, English language, Spanish, principal of business, technical drawing, and she is the joint science student of the year. She has also sat 2 CXE subjects in her third and fourth form years and was successful in both.
Wonderful. Lawrence Solas.
Lawrence is receiving awards in food preparation, information technology, and mathematics in City and Guilds.
Wonderful. Tamaya Stevenson. Romario Tabanor.
Romario is graduating today with credit. He is receiving awards in the following subject areas. Principal of Business, Principal of Accounts, Physical Education, Human and Social Biology, Building and Furniture Technology, Technical Drawing, and he is the Business Student of the Year and the Technical Student of the Year.
This man is a hardworking boy. Next we have Renicia Famos.
Renicia is receiving awards in Food, Nutrition, and Health and Social Studies. She is also the Prefect of the Year and the Joint Vocational Student of the Year. Renicia is Prefect of the Year and Joint Vocational Student of the Year.
Next across the stage, Kaylee Titus.
Kaylee is a graduate with credit today, and her subject areas that she has performed exemplary well in are English language, information technology, and mathematics, city and guilds, food, nutrition, and health, family resource management, and she is the Joint Vocational Student of the Year.
Britannia Walker.
Britannia is a graduate with distinction. She is also our deputy head girl. And she's receiving awards in Principal of Business, Mathematics, Bible, Family Resource Management, Spanish, Biology, Chemistry, History, and Citizenship. She is also the Art Student of the Year.
And we now have Codion Wright.
We now invite a round of applause for all our graduates.
May I invite the graduates to stand for the conferral at this time? Those of you with prizes on your laps, just put them on your seat. Yeah, please stand, everyone. Yes, thank you. No, just graduates, sorry. Dear graduates, you have satisfactorily completed the course of study prescribed at the Victor Dixon High School. It now gives me great pleasure to declare you graduates of the institution. As a result of this new status, you may now shift your tassels. May I invite a round of applause for the newest graduates in town. All right, please be seated. Thank you.
We'll now.
At this time, we will be favored with a musical item from our new graduates. I'm sure you know the difference. You were just a while ago graduates, and now you are graduates. Thereafter, we are also asking the following persons who will be giving some prizes from the business for the business trophy, etc. Miss Lena Nariana, we just ask if you could just come up to the front row. Dr. Vincent Wright, you are in place. The representative for the Citizens Trophy and the Humanities Trophy, please come forward at this time, just in the front row. Thanks.
Prayed with no proof anyone could hear. In our hearts, a hopeful song we barely understood. Now we are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains along before we knew we could. Thank you. swiftly flown away. Yet now I'm standing here with heart so full I can't explain, seeking faith and speaking words I never thought I'd say.
The science department at Northern Caribbean University is always willing to nurture our students. We have been performing in various areas in terms of research. I notice here this afternoon we have a number of students who have done well, even from the fourth form in their CXC in areas of agriculture, biological sciences, and so forth. And I'm quite sure they are going to continue along that trend. We are looking forward to see you all come to NCU to go into the various areas in terms of research, in terms of medicine, engineering, agriculture, biological sciences, and so forth. So we are looking forward for all of you to join us at Northern Caribbean University. And at this time, it offers me great pleasure and privilege to present the trophy from Northern Caribbean University to the awardees.
We invite Joseph Onowere, Samuel Mekla, and Joshe Smith to come forward. They are the Science Students of the Year.
Good evening, everyone, and congratulations, graduating class 2023. I'm here to present the trophy for the best student in business. We have a very good business courses offered. We have human resource management, accounting, marketing, entrepreneurship, finance. We also have hospitality. So we are the best in the country in terms of business model. And if you're trying to get into business, NCU College of Business is the right place.
We invite the Business Student of the Year to come forward, Romario Tabanor. This time, we invite Dr. Alida to the stage.
We are also awarding Outstanding Citizenship Award.
The students for the Citizenship Award are Peter Gordon, Samuel Mekla, Joshe Smith, and Britannia Walker. This time, Mrs. Anya Codling will approach the stage.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the Humanities Department of Northern Caribbean University, it gives me great pleasure to present the next award. Congratulations.
And the Art Student of the Year is Britannia Walker. I now invite Dr. Alida back to the, Vency Alida back to the stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are awarding the vocational award to the top student.
The students for vocational studies are Renicia Thomas and Katie Titus. We now invite Pastor Odika Walker to the stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, we also have at NCU the School of Religion and Theology. It's with great delight I now present the Bible Award to the awardees.
The Bible awardees are Samuel Mekla, Joshua Smith, Joseph Onuweri, Levoni Hansen, Britannia Walker. Aldane Codling. We now invite Dr. Wright to the stage. Dr. Vincent Wright.
Northern Caribbean University is growing from strength to strength. We have recently started our agriculture program, and it's growing. I know Victor Dixon agriculture program is very good. And I want to commend all those who have outperformed themselves in the agriculture area.
The Agricultural Science Awards goes to Ivani Hansen and Krishan Ricketts. We now invite Mr. Danito Mori to the stage.
If you are going to do well in life, you must be able to do well at mathematics. And therefore, it is our delight to announce the Mathematics Award.
The Mathematics Awardees are Sarah Beth Burton, Joseph Onoweri, Joshua Smith, we now invite Mr. Melvin Narayana to the stage.
It is my privilege and honor to congratulate the awardee in the category of information technology.
The students for information technology are Samuel Mekla, Joshua Smith, Burton, can she come?
I think you can go down to her.
Yes, she can come there.
No, you can just go down to her.
Information technology.
Class, graduating class of 2023, I want you to listen to me carefully. Now, Mr. Tabanor is here and can bear me witness, and I'm just giving you two examples because we don't have a lot of time. 8 years ago, I stood in my chemistry class and I told my students, don't go to sixth form, go straight to NCU, do bioscience, and then go to UWE and you can become a doctor. 4 years later, after telling them that, I came to NCU for their graduation. And then, a year later, I went to UWE for their pinning. And my nephew, who went to sixth form, said his mother told me just this week that he wished he had gone to do a degree first because he found out that they were more mature, holistically developed, and sound. Are you ready? Let me hear the round of applause. Now, the 2023 graduating class is special because the education at NCU is on sale. What did I say? It's on sale. So, hear it now. 50% scholarship for freshmen who attended the Campari. There is a 50% scholarship if you are called to the gospel and you're going to join the School of Religion and Theology. Let me hear the round of applause. This is exciting. There is a 35% scholarship for members of this graduating class that are active Adventists. And there is a 20% scholarship for any one of you who decide that you are going to NCU. And to show you this evening that we mean business, we have 4 scholarships to issue this afternoon. Let me hear a round of applause.
On behalf of our president, Dr. Lincoln Paul Edwards, it's my honor and privilege to give these special scholarships, 4 special scholarships for the top performing students here in this class, boys and girls. And the first one is, when I call the names, please come up, okay? The first one is Joshua Smith with a 4.0 GPA. Please come up. A round of... The second one is Samuel Mekala with a 3.95 GPA. And the third one is Britannia Walker with a 3.92 GPA. And the fourth one is Joseph Onowere with 3.81 GPA. Full-time tuition scholarships, freshman scholarship for the academic year 2023 to 2024. God bless you all.
We will be asking Dr. Paul and Mrs. Orchid Smith to remain on stage as we transition into the Parents' Awards. When your name is called, please proceed to the stage.
The Parents Award is given to parents who have been engaged in our meetings, active on our campus, and supportive of our programs.
And we begin with Mr. and Mrs. Michael Beadle, parents of Dillon Beadle. Pastor and Mrs. Peter Gordon, parents of Peter Gordon Jr.
Mr. and Mrs. Lindley Hansen, parents of Levoni Hansen.
Mr. and Mrs. Jason Jackson, parents of Quasia Jackson.
Mr. Lassany Johnson and Miss Nadine Daniels, parents of Lashara Johnson.
Mr. Ewan Lewis and Ms. Rosemary King, parents of Bjorn Lewis.
They are followed by Mr. Burnett McLean and Fenonian Wholeness, parents of Damali McLean.
Mr. and Mrs. Melvin Mekla, parents of Samuel, young Samuel Mekla.
Mr. and Mrs. Naftal Onuweri, parents of Javan and Joseph Onuweri.
Mr. and Mrs. Denton Sharp, parents of Brianna Sharp.
Mr. and Mrs. Gay Patrick Titus, parents of Kaylee Titus.
Ms. Licia Dwyer, parent of Renicia Thomas.
Mr. and Mrs. Odieka Walker, parents of Britannia Walker.
And Mrs. Annette Allen, parent of Sarika Allen. Ladies and gentlemen, may we invite a round of applause for our standing parents. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Each year we like to highlight our teachers, our faithful teachers of the institution. This year we are highlighting two of our longest serving institutional workers, The first is our Dean of Discipline, our Teacher of Technical Drawing and Building and Furniture Construction, Mr. Ian Newman. I invite our chairman. He has been serving the institution since 2000, so over 20 years. We are also highlighting one of our committed and dedicated teachers for over 25 years of service to the school, Mrs. Harriet Foster, our agriculture and science teacher. Next, we have our school chaplain, Mrs. Theresa Richards. And she's also our accounts teacher in fifth form. Mrs. Theresa Richards, she has overseen the transformation of the spiritual program in our school. Thank you so much. And our final award for this category is a special award to our graduation coordinator, and Mrs. Janet Peart has been doing an excellent job for several years. And hats off to you, Mrs. Janet Peart. We appreciate you. We love you. We love all our awardees. We love you, and lots of respect and honor to you today. She's also teacher of English and literature. Give her a round of applause.
Mrs. Orchid Smith, Principal Victor Dixon High School, and her husband, Dr. Joseph Smith. Dr. Lincoln Edwards, President of Northern Caribbean University, represented by Dr. Nanibola Paul, Associate Provost for Academic Affairs, Northern Caribbean University, and Chairman of the Board of Governors, Victor Dixon High School, and her husband, Dr. Emmanuel Paul. Pastor Michael Henry, Education Director, and other representatives of the Jamaica Union of Seventh-day Adventists. Mrs. Roxanne Chambers, Mrs. Roxanne McCoy Chambers, Education Director, Central Jamaica Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. Mrs. Heather Silvera, Lecturer and Coordinator of the Nurse Practitioner Program and Nurse Practitioner, University of the West Indies, guest speaker and family. Other members of the Board of Governors of Victor Dixon High School, specially invited guests, administrators, staff, and students of Victor Dixon High School, alumni, faculty, guardians, and friends joining us physically and on our virtual platform, members of the graduating class of 2023, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. That's not very enthusiastic. I know it's been a little while, but you know, you can give us a good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you. So today we have gathered here to celebrate our achievements, bid farewell to our beloved institution and some of our peers. It is a solemn day, but it's also a day of reflection on our collective experiences, even as we look forward to new beginnings. We stand before you honored and privileged to deliver this valedictorian speech. But it is not just a speech. It is a part of ourselves, a part of our shared experiences. This is a day of nostalgia, gratitude, and inspiration, a moment to acknowledge the incredible journey we embarked upon umpteen years ago.
Although it has already been said, it would be remiss of us not to again express our deepest gratitude to our dedicated, diligent, and distinguished teachers. You stood by us through trials, jubilations, and tribulations, especially our most recent ones, the CXE examinations. We acknowledge that we were not always the most cooperative recipients of your guidance, but through it all, we learned invaluable life lessons that will influence our lives for years to come. Thank you for instilling in us not just knowledge and understanding and a thirst for lifelong learning, but also a desire for Christ-likeness.
Our families, guardians, well-wishers, and friends. I'm going to presuppose that your role is self-explanatory, but considering the care and fervor with which you have supported us, you deserve far more than just an honorable mention.
Notwithstanding, it will have to do for today.
Thank you for your endless love and sacrifices. Your small and great gestures of kindness will never be forgotten. You have been and will continue to be our pillars of strength. We owe our collective success to your unconditional love and guidance, and we are eternally grateful. And even as we laud our parents and teachers and express a deep sense of gratitude to all others who have assisted us on our journey, we must not forget our Creator, who endowed us with the strength to carry on each day and gave us the will to do better.
We thank you, Lord. Fellow graduates, today marks the culmination of years of hard work, dedication, resilience, and determination. Throughout the years, we faced countless exams, sleepless nights, classes in which we hardly understood a thing, days we may not have had lunch money, or days of sadness and despair.
But what doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
And so, we have emerged stronger and more resilient than ever. Each of us has overcome our personal obstacles, whether academic or otherwise, and those trials shaped us into the remarkable individuals we are today.
But there is no going forward without remembering from whence we have come.
We entered Victor Dixon High School one bright September morning, not knowing what awaited us here. As everyone says about their class, we were a special bunch, testing teachers daily with numerous surprises, but also amazing them with our performance. However, we quickly met our matches in the form of dedicated and strict teachers who used special tactics, to say the least, to encourage us to learn. I'm sure you all remember when Mr. Blake would make us read in succession. Even if one person made the slightest mistake, we would have to reread the entire passage, no matter how long it was. And of course, that was how our first form year started and ended, full of new experiences and successes. Our second form year was expected to be no different, or so we thought. The first term was highlighted by an arts department field trip, which we all enjoyed. Second term seemed to proceed as normal, as we had sports day and other activities until the following week, when it was announced that we would get a 2-week break from school due to increasing COVID cases. And that 2 weeks turned into 2 years, in which we would become familiar with online school. We blasted into third form with ease as the best online students. We experienced a few days of mixed Model T school in our second term, which was short-lived as we were quickly sent back online for another term. The first term of fourth form, to be honest, was rather uneventful, but as the content became more difficult, so did learning online. Luckily, we were allowed to return to school in the second term of fourth form, where we resumed our authentic high school experience. Although we were separated by social distancing and masks, being in the same school again was definitely an upgrade from a pictureless tile on a screen. We started SBAs and were pinned as sub-prefects in the third term of fourth form, while looking forward to an eventful fifth form year. We charged full speed ahead into our last first day of high school, with high hopes and expectations. The first few weeks were highlighted by the highly anticipated pinning of prefects. Our CSEC exams seemed like a thing of the distant future, but we had a rude awakening in our second term, as SBAs were due, and mock exams and CSEC exams were approaching fast. But we emerged successful through it all. The third term consisted of numerous revision sessions and stressful CSEC exams, but we were successful, and here we are now. We will never forget the years we spent here at this our soon-to-be alma mater.
As we prepare to leave the familiar halls of this institution, we find ourselves standing on the threshold of a strange world, filled with opportunities and challenges. We must be mindful that we're entering a rapidly changing society, where the only constant is change itself. However, the only way to adapt to the rapidly evolving landscape is to embrace the uncertainties of life, hold fast to the Christian values instilled in us by this noble institution, and embrace those opportunities that we will find through those open doors. It is up to us, the soon-to-be graduates of today, but
We are the graduates now, so it's up to us, the graduates of today, to become the architects of tomorrow's society. It is up to us to better our world.
Friends, success is not defined solely by our accomplishments, but also by the impact we have on others. Even if our achievements rival the Eiffel Tower, without impacting our world, they are all for naught. It is through our actions, yes, big and small, that we can make a difference in the lives of those around us. Whichever course of action we choose to pursue, further education, embarking on our careers, or dedicating ourselves to service, let us strive to leave a lasting and positive legacy. As we approach our highly anticipated conclusion, yes, we know, it's been a minute. Let us never forget the value of gratitude. We must continually take time for reflection on our past experiences so that we can learn and adapt from past mistakes for a brighter future. Always express your appreciation to those who have made a difference in your life and supported you, and don't ever hesitate to lend a helping hand to those in need. Congratulations class of 2023.
We may seldom see each other or our teachers, but let us never forget the lessons learned during our time here.
Everyone can make a difference, and together we will shape a brighter future for ourselves and for generations to come. Let us give our hearts for your dreams and ensure that they become our reality. Go forward, my friends, unlocking the doors to new possibilities and change your world for the better. Hasta que nos volvamos a ver.
Finse non si incontreremo di nuovo.
Till we meet again.
They said you wouldn't make it so far, and ever since they said it, it's been hard. But never mind the nights you had to cry, 'cause you have never let it go inside.
You worked real hard, and you know exactly what you want and need, so believe, and you can never give up. You can reach your goals.
Just talk to you soon and say, I believe I can, I believe I will.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. As we stand before you today, we are filled with immense gratitude to deliver this vote of thanks. It's an honor to be a part of this wonderful gathering of ladies and gentlemen who have come together to celebrate this occasion.
First and foremost, we'd like to express our sincere thanks to the organizers and event coordinators. These include the administration and teaching staff, especially our sponsors who have inspired us with their intelligence, creativity, and drive. The hard work and attention to detail are truly commendable.
To our platform participants, which include our guest speakers and special guests from the Jamaica Union, Central Jamaica Conference, and Northern Caribbean University, your presence is greatly appreciated.
We would like to thank our family and parents, our family and friends, for being our biggest supporters throughout our academic journey. If it weren't for you, we wouldn't be standing here today. And if it weren't for your unwavering love and support.
We owe a debt of gratitude to our caterers, the singers, the volunteers, the media team, the musicians, the ushers, the decorators, and the junior class, who assisted in various ways.
Lastly, we would like to express to our fellow graduates our sincere admiration and respect for all that we have accomplished. We have worked, laughed, and grown together, and we are grateful to have had this opportunity to experience this grand finale with each and every one of you.
Congratulations, class of 2023, and best wishes to your future efforts.
Thank you all.
Matthew 19, verse 26. But Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. Philippians 4:13, the popular one that we know. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And I'm going to give you perhaps your last assignment, graduates and the audience, members of the audience. You can read the story in Luke 5, where Jesus encouraged Simon after he had toiled all night to launch out into the deep. Our theme, unlocking the door to new possibilities. You have sat, you have listened, you have enjoyed yourselves. You have been a wonderful audience. Please clap yourselves. At this point in time, we take down the curtains. The announcements will be done by Mrs. Marie Morgan, followed by our closing prayer, Mrs. Theresa Richards.
Kindly pay attention to the following announcements. Those who are on the platform and our board members, you are asked to repair to S2 for refreshments after. Graduates, no graduates, you have come through this experience. You are going to be given, according to your sponsors, 15 minutes to take pictures, to greet your families and friends in the robes and the regalias that you're in, but you're asked to return them all in 15 minutes after the procession. Those who have special trophies that you got the awards, you may take the original trophies to take pictures, but you'll have to return them also. But you'll keep your replica. We have begun registration for the new school year. Hence, those who wish to be members or matriculate in the school, registration has begun. For first to fourth form, your exams will begin this week, Thursday. Please start preparing for those examinations. If you notice on the back of your program, you have several ways how to support Victor Dixon High School. And we ask for you and even put out a challenge out there for all those who have now especially said goodbye to one of your child or one of your children. We are going to invite you to sponsor another. Maybe someone from your church or someone from your community to be a student at Victor Dixon High School. If that's not possible, you can part sponsor, or you are able to work with the boards at your church to support a student to matriculate at Victor Dixon High School. And you can also contribute to projects. We have some ongoing projects, which are the construction of the water storage tank and also the procurement of computers and tablets and other gadgets for our school. So just pay attention to these, and we welcome the support that you can give. Look out for summer school. It will be coming very soon. But not for you graduates. Yes, you know. But you know also that tomorrow you will be feted and you'll be specially entertained. You know the time. Please pay attention to the time. And you also can listen to your sponsors as to when you meet, where you meet, etc. Okay? God bless you all. And we will now stand for the closing prayer.
Let us bow our heads for prayer. Close your eyes, everybody. Oh, Heavenly Father, it is with grateful hearts that we bow in your presence at this time. We thank you so much for the journey you have led. We thank you for the fact that we have come this far. We are thankful for all of these students, now graduates, who have worked hard and have now seen the fruit of their labor. We are so very thankful for the many supportive parents that we have had. Some of them have made tremendous sacrifices. For each of them, Lord, we say thank you. We are thankful for all the other supporters and stakeholders of this great institution of your planting. And Father, this evening, we want to thank you for taking us through this activity, incident-free. We are most grateful, Lord, that our student, Sarah Beth, who was unable to be with us for some time, was able to make it this evening. And we just want to praise you, oh God, for the success that we are seeing. We praise you because you are God and you are worthy to be praised. As we go from here, we pray that your divine presence will go with us. I commit every single graduate. Some of them are so unaware of what is going to happen after this. Some of them are undecided. Some of them are well sorted out. Whatever the situation, I ask that you will be with each one. Grant us all a blessing. Continue to bless Victor Dixon High School. And we want to ask one more time, Lord, that you will shower down blessings, not only on Victor Dixon, but by extension, Northern Caribbean University. I pray in the name of Jesus that each one of us standing here today will understand how blessed we are and to live accordingly. Dismiss us with your blessing, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to ask, please be seated, everybody. At this time, we are going to be inviting Mr. James, along with some students, to come and to lead out in our school song. Our school song was written by one of our teachers, Mrs. Reed, and the music was added by Mr. James. So we invite him at this time to do the rendition. Thank you so much.
We'll always hold high. Winter.